चैतन्य प्रभु नित्यानंद श्री अद्वैत गदाधर श्रीवासादि गौरभक्तवृंद
जय श्री कृष्ण चैतन्य प्रभु नित्यानंद श्री अद्वैत गदाधर श्रीवासादि गौरभक्तवृंद
हरे कृष्णा 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 हरे 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 रामा राम राम हरे हरे
Krishna Krishna Hare 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 Rama 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 Hare Hare
Hare Krishna 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 Hare 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 Rama Hare Hare
Hare Krishna 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 Hare Hare
Hare Rama
Rama Rama Hare Hare
Hare Krishna 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 Hare 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 Rama 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 Hare Hare
Hare Krishna 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 Hare 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 Rama 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 Hare Hare
Hare Krishna 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 Hare 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 Rama 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 Hare Hare
Hare Krishna 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 Hare 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 Rama 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 Hare Hare
Hare Krishna Mahamantra Ki
Jai
Srila Prabhupada Ki
Jai
Samaveta Bhakta Vrinda Ki
Jai
Jai Gaura Premanande Hare Hare Bol Om Ajnanati Mirandasya Jnananjana Shalakaya चक्षुवन्मीलितं येन तस्मै श्रीगुरवे नमः नमः ओं विष्णुपादाय कृष्णप्रेष्ठाय भूतले श्रीमते भक्तिवेदान्तस्वामिनिति नामिने नमस्ते सारस्वते देवे गौरवाणी प्रचारिणे निर्विशेषाशून्यवादी पाश्चात्यदेशतारिणे वाञ्छाकल्पतरुभ्यश्च कृपा सिन्धुभ्य एव च पतितानां पावनेभ्यो वैष्णवेभ्यो नमो नमः जय श्री कृष्ण चैतन्य प्रभु नित्यानंद श्री अद्वैत गदाधर श्रीवासादि गौरभक्तवृंद हरे कृष्ण 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 हरे 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 राम 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 हरे 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 कृष्णा। So we were doing this cleanliness yesterday, isn't it? We finished a couple of pages and we will proceed further today. Is it big enough? You can see. It's coming there, Prabhu. Okay. Please read this one.
Hare Krishna. Engaging many sweepers, he swept the whole temple and courtyard and then began to wash everything with Ganges water. Lord Chaitanya's devotees splashed water high on the ceilings and walls of the temple, and Chaitanya Mahaprabhu himself wiped the stone altar clean with his own cloth. In his commentary on the section of Chaitanya Charitamrita, Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati takes an internal view of these pastimes and says that unless a devotee makes his own heart perfectly pure of all material taints and desires, then he cannot expect Krishna, who is all pure, to appear there. The Krishna consciousness movement is dedicated to making the world revolutionary clean through hygienic principles, and even more importantly, by cleansing the heart with chanting of Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna,
Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama,
Hare Hare.
So this is the picture, Lord Chaitanya cleaning. You can see this. Lord Chaitanya is personally cleaning. It's coming there?
Yes.
Yeah. And all other devotees, you can see, practically they are sitting on the ground and washing and cleaning. Some devotees were having pots of water passed through a human chain, one after another. And they would take the water from one hand and say, Krishna, Krishna, they would say, and then pass it to the next devotee, Krishna, Krishna, they would say like that. And then in this way, water arrived there, and they would throw, and then the empty pots were also passed out with another human chain. Before throwing water and washing, it was swept with broomsticks. All the gross dust and fine dust were removed first, and then the water was splashed and washed. And Lord Chaitanya is sitting on the top of the Simhasana, where Jagannath will be sitting later on. So Lord Chaitanya himself is cleaning the place, so it has a very deep significance. Why? The Simhasana represents our heart, where the Super Soul is already standing in our heart. So that is the place where we want to invite the divine couple to come and sit. Vrindaranya Kalpadrumada Srimat Ratnagara Simhasanastau Shri Shri Radha Shrila Govinda Devau Preshtalibhi Sevyamano Smarami. We recite that prayer, you know. There is an asana made of ratna. It is mandit with ratna. It is ratnasan in which we keep Radha and Krishna for worship. Similarly, if you want to keep them in our heart, first you have to clean the heart, then the Lordship will agree to come. There are many songs which invite the Lord to come into our heart. One song comes to my mind. Mere man mandir mein ek bar tum a jao giridhari, giridhari vanavari, man mohan kunj bihari pyari. Ah, Javo Giridhari. Very beautiful song, no? O Kunja Bihari, please come and reside in my heart. But for him to reside in our heart, we have to clean the heart first. Just like, imagine you are inviting your spiritual master to your home. Will you just like that invite him? When your home is very dirty, you will throw all garbage out and make it spick and span. You'll put phenol, Dettol, everything. Keep it very, very revolutionary clean. You know that, great souls are very alert and attentive to watch around. Sometimes if some other relatives are coming, we put everything in one side and put a blanket over it. If great souls come, they'll remove the blanket and say, what is this one? So therefore, we have to clean our heart. There's another song, Mama Mana Mandire. There also he says, Raha Nishiddin. Day and night, you please come and reside in my heart. So, this Gundicha Mandir represents our heart, Lordships will be sitting on the Simhasana, which is the we have made a pedestal for the Lord to sit in our heart. It has to be cleaned, first the dust has to be removed, it has to be washed thoroughly. So in India, Swachh Bharat mission is there, due to which now in the last few years a lot of cleaning has been happening. But that is only material cleanliness. But Prabhupada is talking about spiritual cleanliness. Like for example, one of the 26 qualities of a devotee is called Shuchi. That way, if you go to IT companies, they keep it very spick and span. Are they pure devotees? You see, all the flooring is so clean, it looks like a mirror. They keep it so nice, the employees. So which means, pure devotees are clean. All clean people who keep places clean, they are not pure devotees. You should know that. Simply by keeping clean, we don't become pure devotee. But if you are a pure devotee, you will be clean. And that is one of the symptoms. Because external cleanliness is not that all that matters. People may keep their home very clean or office very clean, and they may be eating meat and drinking wine in the same office. What kind of cleanliness is that? So our cleanliness actually should be external and internal both, like you said just now.
During the rainy season, all living entities...
No, the one para. When?
When some of Srila Prabhupada's disciples were accused of brainwashing, a charge that was quickly thrown out of the court. Srila Prabhupada took the word brainwashing in a favorable way and said, that was indeed our mission. Because their brains are filled with stool, he said, we have to wash their brains with chanting of the Lord's names.
Their brains are filled with all kinds of bogus theories like Darwin's theory and Big Bang theory and many such perishable, temporary, short-term theories. So, therefore we have to cleanse. Not only that, not only people are unaware of knowledge about God and living forms, they also have no knowledge of the culture, habits, good habits, behavior. They don't know what are the right eating habits, sleeping habits, mating habits, what is proper conduct. People have no knowledge. So people's heads are filled with dirt, which has to be cleansed, he said. I read further.
During the rainy season, all living entities in the land, sky, water become very much refreshed, exactly like one who engages in the transcendental loving service of the Lord. We have practical experience this with our students in ISKCON. Before becoming students, they were dirty looking. Although they had naturally beautiful personal features, due to having no information of Krishna consciousness, they appeared very dirty and wretched. Since they have taken to Krishna consciousness, their health has improved. And by their following the rules and regulations, their bodily luster has increased. When they are dressed with saffron colored cloth, with tilak on their foreheads and beads in their hands and on their necks, they look exactly as if they have directly come from Vaikuntha.
Hari bol. Prabhupada wrote this in Krishna book. Actually, there were many professors in America who came to meet Prabhupada one-to-one. So they very gladly and openly expressed, Swamiji, we cannot believe our eyes. Your disciples have a certain luster on their face, a shine and a smile and cheerfulness. How this has come about? Earlier they were taking to drugs and, you know, smoking and drinking and all bad habits. So Prabhupada said, the very lifestyle of a Krishna conscious devotee, like here he says, you see, you know, when their health has improved because they take only prasad and they follow the rules and regulations, so the bodily luster has increased. When you follow the rules and regulations, then you get a tej on the face. And they are dressed in saffron cloth with kantimala, neck beads and bead bag, and with forehead wearing tilaks. They look like Vaikuntha men. The Prabhupada said. Okay, now we are going to read from various lectures of Prabhupada on cleanliness. Yes. Yeah.
Lecture in 1976. If we don't lead a Brahmanical life, we are not allowed to call ourselves Brahmanas. You may be son of respected High Court judge, but if you do not have required qualification, you cannot call yourself a judge. There has to be an institution for training and educating Brahmanas. Everyone should be classified according to his education and his qualities.
Yeah, correct. Son of a Brahman is not a Brahman. Son of a lawyer is not a lawyer. Son of a doctor is not a doctor. Everybody has to qualify. There's a verse which says, Janmana jayate shudraha samskarat bhavet bija Vedapathat Bhaved Vipra Brahmajanati Iti Brahmana. Four categories of people. Everybody is born Shudra, and one who Janmajati Shudra Samskarat. If you do purificatory ceremony, then you become a Dvija. And then if you study the Vedic part, then you become Vipra. And then you become a knower of the soul and the soul's difference from the body. You are enlightened about it, Aham Brahmasmi. Then you are a Brahmana. Then you act like a Brahmana. Om Tad Vishnum Paramam Padam Sada Pashyanti Sureha Diviva Chakshur Atadam Viprasa Vipanyo Jagravam Samindate Om Tad Vishnum Paramam Padam. So this verse says that just like when there is sun in the sky, you don't have to go outside the room in the street to look at the sun. But from the sunlight, you can confidently say that there is sun in the sky. Similarly, the Brahmanas are people who have complete faith in Lord Vishnu. They can see the display of Vishnu's energies. Eka desha sitasya agner jyotsna vistarani yata parasya brahmana shaktis tate dhammakhyalam jagat. This verse says that in one place the sun is there, but then it is spreading light all over the universe. From here, if you see the sunlight brightly, without seeing sun, you can say sun exists. Similarly, the Brahmanas can see Lord, Supreme Lord's energy spreaded in this world, by which very confidently they can say there is a Vaikuntha and the Lord is residing there. And they have 101% faith in that, firm faith. Then you become actually a Brahmana. And such Brahmanas are very alert and attentive to in performing their duties, especially keeping clean. They'll never wear a dress if it is not washed, and many other things Prabhupada will say now, Brahminical standards. Read the second one.
Shri
Vigrahāradhana Nityanāna Shringāra Tanmandira Vārjanādau Yuktasya Bhaktamshchani Yunjato Api Vande Guru Shri Charanaravindam. Yes.
Marjanādau means cleansing. The spiritual master along with his disciple is always engaged in cleansing the temple of Shri Radha Krishna.
Prabhupada said, actually I established more than 100 centers all over the world, and it is my duty, because I have established Radha Krishna Gauranitai, I am supposed to clean the deity room and take care of the deity every morning. But can I do that for all 100 temples? I can't do it. So all of you disciples, you are like my extended hands. So you have to help me in all these temples to take care of the deities very nicely. And if you do it very perfectly, and if the news reaches me, I'll be happy, then Krishna will be pleased also. So the disciple should know that I am actually doing the work of the Guru. Guru has given me this service. But if you are not very keeping very clean, then a disciple will feel, oh, this deity has become a big burden. If deity was not there, you know, life would be more easier. So then the vigraha becomes galagraha, like that he says. Yes.
If the cleanliness is neglected, it is a sure sign of laziness. If one is lazy, one does not keep his environment clean. First, let me sleep. This is the mode of ignorance, tamoguna. We have to overcome rajaguna and tamoguna. Satvam vishuddham vasudeva shabditam. The heart has to be pure if we want to receive Krishna and allow him to reside there pleasantly.
Yeah. So that we have to begin with external cleanliness and faithfully taking care of the altar deities. For example, if prasadam you have to take in the morning at 8 o'clock, and the bhoga offering has to, you know, reach at 7:15 or 7:30, whatever time is fixed, it should go on time. And then the Lord should be allowed to take it in 15 minutes, you should give whatever time, and then it should be taken out. Not that 8 o'clock all are going to eat and then you keep 7:55 and just show it and take it away and then make a show of offering. Lord is observing it, watching it. Then Lord knows these fellows are not sincere. Then it is not prasadam. It is just, you know, like karmi food only. So one has to be very sincere in the deity worship. Punctuality is very important. Cleanliness is important. Like, you know, for example, if you have a glass, you have a lid for the glass. You keep the lid down. And again, after putting water, you keep it up. Is it proper? Why? All the dust from the bottom of the lid will go into the water. Or if some ant was down, you will catch the ant like this and put it inside. Correct, no? Similarly, Prabhupada asked somebody to bring water. So that devotee brought water to Prabhupada in a glass and he put his finger inside. like this. Prabhupada said, don't throw this. This is not pure. Because you are putting your finger inside the water. So therefore, Brahmana actually means one who is observant about his activities. One time His Holiness Bhaktivikas Swami Maharaj came to Pune. So one devotee was sitting in the class and putting his finger inside the mouth to take out some, you know, after eating prasad, sometimes something gets stuck up, no? In the mouth. He was trying to remove that, like this. And Maharaj saw that and said, hey! And Maharaj pointed out like this. Get up! He said, immediately jumped up in his place. He said, go and wash your hand and come. Immediately the devotee ran away. He was a little afraid. Then after washing the hand, he came back. And when he sat, Maharaj said, did you know? Why did I tell you this? He said, no, Maharaj. Prabhupada told me. He said. So, in this way, Prabhupada was very observant. Like some devotees, one day were eating in the kitchen. I mean, not in the kitchen, outside the kitchen. They were eating prasad. After eating prasad, Prabhupada was sitting in a chair and talking. So, they didn't get up. Naturally, the hands get a bit dry, no? When you have a prasadam plate is dry. So, some devotees kept the hand down like this. Prabhupada said, no, you cannot keep down. Because this hand is used by you for eating. And they were wondering, why you can't keep down? Anyway, we are going to wash this place anyway. Why can't you keep it down? No, it's a jutta hand. You cannot keep it. Similarly, devotees thought that if you take a spoon with which you eat, and then you put the spoon for washing, they thought you don't have to wash the hand. Correct, no? Why? Because I use spoon only for eating. My hand is clean. No. It's like electric connection. If you take like this and put in the mouth, you do like this. From mouth, the connection goes to spoon and through the spoon goes to the hand also. So now this is also impure now. So this is the Vedic standard. Many times we may not be aware of these things. You see? Like for example, we are eating prasad and we are not allowed to again use another hand to serve. In South India, what they will do, if they have to serve prasad, they will keep some water nearby. Next to them, they will sprinkle some water and keep. If they have to serve, they will touch the water and then serve. And then they will again touch the water. It's like you purify your hand and then you serve. In ISKCON standard, we don't do that also. We actually wash our hand and then come back and we serve. If you have to do self-service. We have to do a lot of. So therefore, that will come in the prasadam section, it will come. To the degree a person is very attentive to follow these cleanliness standards, to that degree he will be able to know what is impure, what is pure. Can clearly see. So he will not act impurely. Over a period of time, it will be difficult for you to act impurely. For example, sometimes one is sneezing, then you suddenly put your hand, take out something, and there is no one is around, you put it on the wall. Like this. Why people do that? You see, if another friend is nearby, will you do that? Somebody is watching, no one is around, do you think? Because Super Soul is also watching. Hey, what are you doing with it in the wall? You are making the wall impure. Why don't you go there to the dustbin, throw it and then wash your hands and wash your nose and come? Why do you just put it on the wall? See? So therefore, see how many of you are understanding what I am saying? Is it only I am saying or you have seen such things? Correct, no? Correct, no? So, we do act impurely many times. But to the degree we work on acting cleanly, then gradually it becomes very easy to come to spiritual life after that. See, Prabhupada to Rishikumar, what he said?
Srila Prabhupada to Rishikumar. Krishna consciousness means to have a clean bead bag.
When I read this, after that I kept my bead bag. I make sure I don't keep a black bead bag. One time His Holiness Jayadutt Maharaj came to Pune and he saw 4 or 5 bead bags were hanging in the temple hall and they were extremely blackish, very dirty and, you know, lying. He asked, why are these dead rats hanging here? Like that he asked. And everybody were looking, where are the rats? He called the bead bags as rats. They look so dirty. Take it out, it doesn't look good in the temple hall you are selling. Similarly, Prabhupada once saw one devotee. He was talking to one devotee and then Prabhupada saw that a bead bag was hanging in the bathroom door. Because the devotee went to bathroom and came, he left the bead bag hanging there. Prabhupada asked, why is this bead bag hanging here for 300 years? He asked. He said, Prabhupada, 300 years, I am not even 300 years old. Prabhupada said, 300 years means for a very long time. Why is it here in the bathroom door? Keep it in a more holy place. Because bead bag should not be touching the bathroom door. That's an impure thing, this is a pure thing. So therefore, we should keep pure things in a pure place. Impure things should be kept separate. I read further.
In the early days of the movement, Srila Prabhupada instructed the devotees to clean their plates and the cooking pots right after honoring prasadam. When one of the leaders saw that devotees were not following his order, he asked Srila Prabhupada which method he should use to get the devotees to the point of following. Srila Prabhupada, the order of spiritual master should be sufficient, replied Srila Prabhupada.
We have to know these orders and follow them. Yes, next.
In Dallas and Edinburgh, the devotees complained that there were rats in the temple. So they asked Srila Prabhupada whether they were allowed to kill them. Srila Prabhupada's answer was, no, you should be killed because you took the vow of cleanliness but did not keep it.
See, you are supposed to be clean, you don't keep it clean, and when rats come, you want to kill them. You should be killed. Actually, it is a fact that if a place is thoroughly clean, actually in my room also one small rat used to come. So my assistant was trying to catch the rat. He put a rat trap and he even put one date palm laddu. But the rat didn't come at all. Because the rat requires something nice smelling. Then he put pakoda next day. Pakoda, it attracts immediately. Then I asked why. Then I told there should be nothing touching the ground. Then we lifted up everything up. No, don't put any clothes, don't put. Then the rat will not come only. Because rat always needs what? A hiding place. If there is no hiding place, will he come? He will think, hey, this room is a risky room. There is no place for me to hide. He will go away. So therefore, keep clean and they will not come. He is saying. And also you will see certain people, the vessels and other things, along with, you know, dal and little bit of sabji and everything, people put it in the wash basin. You have seen that? With some little water also in that. And very easily cockroaches come. Cockroaches, rats. Because they get little food, they come, and then they multiply eventually over a bit of time. Similarly, you keep a dustbin where you put paper also, and you put in, wet items also, like sabji and everything you throw in. Gradually, it becomes like a compost starts stinking, and the smell also comes, and mosquitoes, they find it like a wonderful breeding place. Then you wonder, where are the mosquitoes coming from suddenly? Because actually, you create facility, an unclean facility for the mosquitoes to breed, for the cockroaches to come, rats to come. So Prabhupada's point is, don't give them any room. Yes. Next.
Srila Prabhupada once wrote to one devotee in London, each room should be as clean as a mirror, otherwise you will invite the rats.
Next.
Once when Srila Prabhupada was on morning walk in Hawaii, he passed by the prasadam room. Seeing him, the devotees were in so much ecstasy that they dropped everything and ran after Prabhupada. His divine grace led everyone on the compound and then returned to the temple room. Soon later, Guru Kripa complained to Prabhupada about the leftover prasadam and the unclean prasadam room, and also mentioned how he had difficulties to bring devotees to the point of cleaning. Srila Prabhupada, if a devotee does not clean, he can go home again and live with his mother.
Prabhupada told him, if a devotee doesn't clean, he can go home and live with the mother and learn cleanliness at home. Like that he said. Read the next one.
When you are clean, you are in the spiritual world, Vaikuntha. When you are dirty, you are in the material world.
Yeah. See, first time, my experience with cleanliness, I will tell you. I had gone to Chaupari temple. There was one devotee called Damodar Pandit Prabhu. He used to wear pure white kurta and pure white dhoti and pure white bead bag. He was wearing that. It was so clean. Shining like lightning practically. And he'll be clean shaved also. Very effulgent devotee. So when I first saw him there, it's a grihastha devotee who resided in the temple. and he was doing a lot of services. Later on he moved to Mira Road. But I was deeply inspired just by seeing him. I also developed a desire that, you know, I will wear a clean dhoti kurta and a clean bead bag. On that day I decided I'll keep things very clean. Otherwise, prior to that, I remember the bead bag used to become a little blackish in the corners and all, correct, no? It becomes a little blackish in the corner. Sometimes kurta also becomes a little blackish. You are just washing in water. So, actually, if devotees look very effulgent and clean and neat and they wear a very nice tilak, kandipala, it also inspires people to take to Krishna consciousness seriously. So, therefore, Prabhupada used to say, first dress and then address, used to say. Wherever you go to give any seminar, any lecture, first you should dress yourself properly and then you can address the people. So, the Prabhupada says, when you are clean, you are in spiritual world, Vaikuntha. He says, when you are dirty, you are in material world. He says, yeah. Next, ninth one.
Those who do not regularly bathe are supposed to be in association with ghosts and crazy creatures.
See here, if somebody is lazy to bathe, actually some people take only crow bath in the morning. You know what is crow bath? Crow bath means they get up at 4:25 and then quickly, that they take from the bucket, you know. They put bucket, most of the water goes down, it doesn't come in their body. Yeah? And therefore the body still has sweat of the previous day. So that is not a proper bath. Then the ghost will come to us, he says. So then one has to take proper bath in the day. Two, three times a day one has to take bath. Yeah. And then practical aspects of cleanliness in everyday life. You have read it?
Practical aspects. Fresh clothes must be worn in the temple. Once we wear a dress once, then it is not fit to be preserved to be worn again for the second time. It should be washed before it can be worn. Thus, every morning, devotee should always wear only freshly washed clothes.
Yeah. So, especially the students who come into our centers in the third semester, they may be aware or they may not be aware, but they should become aware of this. Once you wear it, the clothes become juta. Juta means, just like a plate, once you eat, it becomes, your saliva has touched it. So then, unless you wash the plate, you can't take for the second time in that plate. Same with dress also. Once you wear, bodily sweat comes in this and everything. So we have to wash it. Without washing, one should not wear it second time. Yeah. Yes?
After one takes prasad, the area where the plate was kept must be cleared. One should not step over that area, the area where prasad was taken, because it is considered contaminated. The place where we take prasad becomes contaminated. And if one steps on that spot, then feet must be washed.
By mistake, you put your feet and some rice particle, dal particle is sticking to your feet. What you should do? Immediately wash. Go and wash. Yeah.
The place where prasad has been taken must be cleaned right after the prasad has been taken, because the temple must be very clean. We should be careful that we do not unnecessarily contaminate the temple.
One day in Chaupati temple, Varanda, His Holiness Bhaktichara Maharaj and His Holiness Radhanath Maharaj, they both were coming, walking. And suddenly Bhaktichara Swami Maharaj saw there was some kichdi, this much kichdi was lying on midway. So he walked like this and it was like, he didn't walk over it. It was little prasad lying. And Radhanath Maharaj immediately said, where is Gauranga? Maharaj asked. Immediately Gauranga Prabhu came there. Maharaj said, what is this? He said, Gauranga said, Maharaj, it's kichdi. Yeah, kichdi, but why is it here? Huh? Immediately it should be cleaned. Maharaj, today morning after the Bhagavatam, devotees are sitting here, there, everywhere and they are taking. Once everybody is over, then we will clean. Maharaj said, no, as soon as it falls, you have to clean. Immediately. It should not be lying here, there, in patches. You know, we should not wait till everybody's prasad is over and then you clean. And then Gauranga said, Maharaj, for that we have to keep on servant moving around, watching. Yes, Maharaj, that's the right thing. We should not allow it to be lying like that, he said. We should keep it very clean. So Maharaj is very particular. So, in this way, as soon as we finish prasad, it should not be becoming dry and sticky, and then later on cleaning will become very difficult. It should be immediately cleaned, he says. Actually, for this, devotees have to be very conscious of this. Yeah, otherwise, it's not possible without that. Yeah. Yes.
One should not enter temple hall without having washed one's hand and feet after eating. One should enter temple with clean hands and feet. One should take bath after passing stool and only then enter the temple hall. When one passes stool, the whole body becomes contaminated. One should immediately take a bath and only then proceed with other activities. After cutting nails, shaving beard or head, passing stool, one should take a bath.
So now some boys ask that, you know, Prabhu, if I take two, three baths in a day, I get cold, I get sick. So the easiest thing is what? You store, don't take under a shower. You store in a bucket, take bath from the neck down, and lastly, when you are about to conclude your bath, just put a little bit and immediately wipe it. That way you will not get sick. But one has to take a bath after all these things. Yeah, yes.
One should not enter temple after visiting crematorium or after touching a dead body. One must first take proper bath and then enter.
Yeah.
One should not pass air or belch within the temple. One should avoid putting one's finger in one's mouth, ear or nose while in temple. When one is compelled to do this, even outside the temple, one's hands must be washed immediately thereafter. Under all circumstances, chanting on one's japa beat should continue. There can be no material impediment to the chanting of the holy name. As far as one's home is concerned, Mataji should try to maintain the above standard where possible. In some cases, it may not be practical and possible to do that, as there may be no one else available to do the cooking, etc. In such cases, Matajis may do the needful to fulfill their domestic obligations and at the same time also see that their household duties are taken care of. Other members of family, as far as possible, should help in this regard.
Yeah. So this is all about cleanliness. Now we are going to the next topic, which is philosophy and benefits of deity worship today. So, see, all of us, we all have, even before we came to Krishna consciousness, we are eager to know how God would look like. He must be a very big person or a great person. Sometimes they draw God as a person with a long beard, thinking that being the oldest person, he must have the longest beard. And he must be a very old person. But in Brahma Samhita he says, Adhyam Purana Purusham Navayavanam Cha. He is the oldest person, still he always looks very young and ever fresh and youthful. He looks like that. So the soul always hankers to see the beautiful form of the Lord. And why is it important for us to see the beautiful form of the deities? Actually, because our eyes are hankering to see beauty. If we don't see that beauty, then we will turn to material beauty. You will see that the living entities are also charming and very attractive to look at because they are part and parcels of Krishna. Being part and parcels of Krishna, they have minute beauty and Krishna has oceanic beauty. So if you are unaware of the oceanic beauty of the Lord, then you are going to be settling with some temporary beauty. Then man is attracted to woman, woman is attracted to man. It becomes a sentimental, emotional connection in this world. And then one falls for temporary fleeting beauty, as we say. Or sometimes you may even become an impersonal worshipper. Because you don't know about the beauty of God, then one may think that God has no form, no hands, no legs. Then one thinks God is like a big shining light or something. One goes for such a... Either one, both are dangerous. One leads you to Maya, another one leads you to impersonal, effulgence of Krishna, which is also only a effulgence of the Lord. Therefore, it is very important for one to know about the form of the Lord and His beauty, and one should get an opportunity to see. So the Lord appears in His personal form in this world. Actually, when He appears in this world, He can appear in His same spiritual form. It's not difficult for him. But we don't have the eyes to see. Correct, no? So therefore the Lord says to Uddhava, in the 11th canto of Bhagavatam, you know, my devotees in this world make my deity forms in one of the Ashtadhatus, the eight elements. And although they are apparently material elements, when my devotee worships me with great sincerity, I appear to them in that particular deity form and I reciprocate with them. He says that. So here is quoting this one. चिंतामणि प्रकर सद्मसुकल्प वृक्ष लक्षावृतेषु सुरवीर विपालयन्तं लक्ष्मी सहस्रशत संभ्रम सेव्यमानं गोविंदमादिपुरुषं तमहं भजामि वेणुं क्वणन्तमरविन्द दलायताक्षं बर्हावतं समसितं बुधसुन्दरांगं कन्दर्पकोटिकमनीय विशेषशोभं गोविंदमादिपुरुषं तमहं भजामि आलोलचंद्रकलसत्वनमाल्यवंशी रत्नांगदं प्रणयकेलिकलाविलासं श्यामं त्रिभंगललितं नियतप्रकाशं गोविंदमादिपुरुषं तमहं भजामि. वेरी सिंपल सांस्क्रिट, ईजिली कैन अंडरस्टैंड. He says, Chintamani Prakara Sadmasu Kalpa Vriksha. He is saying the spiritual world has fine golden dust of Chintamani, like shining diamond, like gems, which is the sand of the Goloka. Everywhere you find, if you take one particle of that sand, even the whole material world, if you sell, it will not equal to that. It is so costly, but it is very freely lying in the bank of Yamuna. That is Chintamani. And he is saying, Kalpa Vriksha, there are desire trees which can supply you any fruit or any garland or anything that you may want. Desire trees. And then there are numberless cows which give unlimited supply of milk any time of the day, any day, all day. They can give portion of milk, they can give. And he is saying, and there are Sahasra Shata means 100,000 Lakshmis. That means unlimited Lakshmis are there who are serving the Lord, gopis. Are serving Krishna there. And then he is saying, oh, this is about the opulence of the spiritual world. Then he goes on to say the Lord's particular form. He is saying, Venum Kwanantam, he plays on his Venu. Aravindadalaya Taksham, his eyes are like lotus petals. Barhavatamsam, he has a peacock feather. Asitambuda Sundarangam, his body is of the color of a fresh monsoon cloud. So very clearly it says, eyes are like lotus petals, he plays on a flute, he wears a peacock feather. Kandarpa koti kamaniya visheshubham, crores of madans will fall unconscious seeing his beauty. And the next verse he says, Alola chandrakalasat vanamalya vamshi, his forehead is like a crescent moon. And vanamalya, he also wears a vanamala in his neck, beautiful garland he wears. Ratnangadam pranayakeli kalavi, he wears a kaustubha jewel, necklace. And armlets, bracelets and everything he wears, Nupur, everything he wears, jewellery put by Yashoda. Alola chandra kalasat vanamalyavam chiratnangadam pranayake likala vilasam. Shyamam, his color is of bluish black, shyamam. Shyamam tribhangalalitam, there are threefold bending form. There is one bend in the neck like this, another bend in the hip like this, hip is more on this side. And then third bend is in the lotus feet, is keeping the right leg like this, in the front he is keeping. So this is actually a pose in which Krishna is lovingly looking at his devotees. Like when you are in NCC, they tell you to stand erect, like this. And you have to keep the leg like a V, correct, no? You have to keep like this and stand in the NCC, with your chest raised. Like that you have to, you have seen that in NCC you are like that, isn't it? Whereas that is actually official posture. When it comes to loving posture, if somebody like your brother, sister, mother, father, somebody is talking to you, you may keep like this. Go ahead, tell me. Like that you will. So Krishna is also keeping like this, bending, lovingly bending his face and hearing his devotees. So in this way he is saying Tribhanga Lalitam. So all these are descriptions given in the scriptures, and the deity form of the Lord is made exactly according to these descriptions. And you can see how Vrindavan Chandra is so beautiful. So, read that. There is no difference between?
There is no difference between the form of the Lord and Lord Himself. On the material platform, a person and his picture, for instance, are different. Seeing a picture of a friend may remind us of that friend. But the picture is only representation, not the friend himself.
Because you can't speak to that picture. Maybe you can speak, but your friend may not come to know what you spoke to that picture, isn't it? So, because the person is not absolute. Whereas Krishna is absolute. He is present in every atom. Sarvada panipadam tat sarvato akshi shiro mukham sarvada shrutiman loke sarvam avritya tishthati. In Gita he says that. सर्वदा पानी माय हैंड्स आर एवरीवेयर पानी पादम माय लेग्स आर एवरीवेयर सर्वतो अक्षी माय आईज आर इन एवरी एटम एंड द आईज नेवर ब्लिंक ऑल्सो दे आर वॉचिंग यू यू मे नॉट सी मी सर बट आई एम सीइंग यू हि सेज सर्वतो अक्षी शिरो मुखम माय फेस एंड माय हेड आर एवरीवेयर सर्वतः श्रुतिमन लोके माय इयर्स आर शार्प आई एम हियरिंग व्हाट यू आर स्पीकिंग एट एवरी मोमेंट एनीवेयर यू मे बोल्ट यूर रूम डोर एंड टॉक समथिंग एंड आई एम हियरिंग इट इज हु कृष्णा इज हियरिंग यू कैन नॉट एस्केप बिकॉज ही इज सर्वतः श्रुतिमन लोके इज सेज सर्व आवृत्य तिष्ठति इन दिस वे आई हैव परमिएटेड द होल मटेरियल वर्ल्ड गोलोक निवसति अखिलात्म भूतो आई एम एवरीवेयर इन दिस वर्ल्ड सो इन दिस वे लॉर्ड इज एवरीवेयर इवन ही इज इन द पिक्चर ऑल्सो ही इज इनसाइड द पिक्चर ही इज इन द डेटी फॉर्म बिकॉज ऑल द मटेरियल्स हैव कम फ्रॉम हिम दिस मटेरियल डिड यू क्रिएट फ्रॉम योर बॉडी डिड यू क्रिएट दिस वन डिड यू क्रिएट दिस टेबल डिड क्रिएट दिस चेयर ऑल दिस मटेरियल्स आर simultaneously one with Krishna and separate from Krishna also. Actually, we call this world as a separated energy. Actually, it is not separated in one sense. I'll tell you how. Actually, Prabhupada writes, the material world, from Lord's point of view, is not separated. But from our point of view, it is separated. When the jivas look at the world with the enjoying mentality, then only they see it as separated for their enjoyment. But the Lord sees no difference between Yoga Maya and Mahamaya. All the energies are emanating from Him only. Like for example, your family, grihastha family, a man, say, he comes in a big car to the temple and he's getting out of the car, big fellow, walking like this. And then a big man, crorepati, like that, is pulling out a purse and putting 1 rupee coin in the hundi. And then he's going back, which means this 1 rupee is for Krishna and crores of rupees for me. He is seeing it separately, like that. On the other hand, a devotee who has no bank account only, his body is Krishna's property. His mind is Krishna's property. Words are Krishna's property. Does he see difference? He doesn't see. For him, he himself belongs to Krishna only. He is Krishna's property. But a man who is not in that way fully dedicated, he will see difference between the two. So therefore, you will see that for Krishna, everything is spirit only. And he can manifest himself from anywhere he wishes. Like Narsingadev is jumping out from a pillar. Somebody may ask, who are the parents of Narsingadev? The pillar is the parent. Because he has no parent. He is a parent of everybody else. Aham Bija Prada Pita. He can jump out, or he can come from the nose of Brahma as a Varahadeva. Or he can come as Vamanadev from Aditi's womb. He can come as Vasudev from Devaki's womb. It is his choice. Whether actually he accepts parents as a pastime. Actually, did we accept our parents as a pastime? You know, we were put in some family and we were given a face cut, everything. Whereas the Lord appears in a devotee's womb just to please the devotee that, see, I appeared from your womb, I am your child. So the devotee is overwhelmed with love, seeing that the Lord appeared from my body and I am feeding milk for the Lord like that. You see? So therefore, Lord can appear from anywhere He wishes. If He wishes from the deity form, the deity can suddenly walk out of the altar. Just like what our Purushottam Chobe, who was a Shishya, disciple of Advaita Acharya Prabhu. He had one deity in his home called Madan Gopal. He used to call him as Madan Gopal. And the name was changed by Sanatana Goswami as Madan Mohan. Why? Because that Madan Gopal one day was playing with the boys outside. And when he saw him, he called him as Madan Mohan. Who? Sanatana Goswami, yeah. So the boy was having a very charming face. There was a glow on his face and sweetness on his face, in his eyes, in his curly hair, and his smile. It was very captivating to him. But then he saw, standing in one place and watching the boy with unblinking eyes. But the boy ran away from that place after the games were over. He went into the home of Purushottam Chobe and Sanatan walked behind him. And he saw the Lord running into the altar, and he got up on the altar and he stood there. And then he told Purushottam Chobe, take care of your deities. They are going out to play, he said. Which means the Lord can look like a, you know, doll made of stone or metal or something, but he is not limited by it. He can any time, you know, make himself appear spiritually, as he says here, and he can play. It's possible. Like the government can use the same paper to make a newspaper, or it can use the same paper to print a currency note, can't they? Its government has the freedom. He can do that. Similarly, the Lord can manifest through the matter, because when you see currency note, you keep in the packet. When you see a newspaper, you put in raddi, you know, in the this thing, waste paper. So read this.
How does Lord change matter into spirit?
Yeah.
He does so when he appears by the grace of his devotee as the transcendental form of the deity. When a pure devotee paints or carves the form of the deity and calls upon the Lord to kindly agree to accept his humble service, the Lord agrees to do so, provided everything is done according to the scriptural regulations. One's sincere attitude of service to the Lord and strict adherence to the rules of scriptures are essential ingredients that make the deity worship vastly different from the worship of an ordinary idol.
Yeah. Tvam bhakti yoga paribhavita hrit saroj aseshu te kshitapato nananata pumsam yadyad diyata urgaya vibhavayanti tattat vapu pranayase sadanugrahaya. In this verse he says, the Lord Brahma says, tvam bhakti yoga paribhavita hrit saroj, deeply inspired by the devotion of a devotee, you appear in the lotus of the heart of your devotee and you stand there, inspiring the devotee further and further in devotional service. And such devotees develop a greed, spiritual greed, to want to worship you in a particular form. Like they want to worship you as Krishna, or Rama, or as Vishnu, or Narasimha, or Varaha, any one particular form. They develop a great fondness for you. And then you agree to come in that form and reciprocate with the devotee, like that he says. So Lord can agree to come in a certain form to please his devotee. Because different devotees are touched by the different leelas of the Lord. So the example is given of a post office and an authorized mailbox. Because the post office is often far away from the home, so they have put many, many boxes across the city in various places. You know, in those days we used to write a mail, a snail mail we call it. And then you put it in the box, and you know, the post office will have a certain timing in which they will go and collect all the posts from the different boxes and take it to the main post office, and from there they dispatch the things. Similarly, there are hundreds and thousands of deities across the globe which are authentically installed by Acharyas and Vaishnavas, correct, no? So if Krishna wants to receive offerings through these deities, is it difficult for him? Is there any difficulty? You know, if we can do such a post box mechanism, what is the difficulty for him? I heard one time one devotee was telling me, in your mobile, as soon as your amount is finished, then they give an indication that your amount is getting over. If you don't pay, we will cut. What do you call that? Service will be terminated until you pay the amount, correct, no? So then I asked, who does this so perfectly, keeping track of so many people? They said, Prabhu, they keep track of crores of mobiles. Only one man is doing it from his sitting in the room. And through computer program, everything, they can do it. So if one man can control hundreds and thousands and lakhs of mobiles of different people and terminate the services and sometimes activate the service, he is doing. So for Lord to, you know, be in the Dugdha Sagar, milk ocean, as a super soul, in the lying there, and then expand himself as super soul in everybody and activate, is it very difficult? Similarly, Krishna can also accept the services from all the deity forms in this world, even though he is situated in the spiritual world. Yeah. So then, right now we have blunt material eyes, we are unable to see him. Then how can we see him then? Ata Sri Krishna Namadi Nabhaved Grahyam Indriya. Grahyam means blunt senses. With this blunt senses we cannot see him properly. Sevon Mukehi Jihvado Swayameva Swaratyadaha. When you render the services to Krishna, when he is pleased by your service, then he will give you the prema chakshu. Premanjanachurita bhakti vilochanena santas sadaiva hridayeshu vilokayanti, says. When the prema chakshu comes, Lord enters your heart through your eyes, and he goes and resides there in your heart permanently, always. Actually, everybody is seeing the deity form, Why some people are extremely charmed and extremely touched. They develop feelings for the deities. They offer prayers to deities. They get reciprocation from the deity. Why? Because the Lord is pleased with their service attitude. Then He reciprocates with them. And there are others who may look at the deity as a duty or as a ritual. They may just bow down or whatever. So it's not possible for us to see the Lord with our blunt senses. We have to have service attitude. If the service attitude is pleasing to Him, then He will reveal Himself more and more to us. So therefore we begin with the tongue. Tongue does two activities, chanting the Hare Krishna mantra and also taking prasadam. And then gradually become pure. So, yeah, read this one, significance.
Significance of the Lord descending in deity form. The form of the Lord as worship in the temples is called Archa Vigraha or Archavatar, the worshipable form, the deity incarnation. This facility is offered to a neophyte devotees so that they can see the real form of the Lord face to face and offer their respectful obeisances and sacrifices in the form of Archa. Through such facilities, the neophytes gradually invoke their original Krishna consciousness. Deity worship in the form of temple worship is a most valuable benediction given by the Lord to beginners. All neophytes must therefore engage in the worship of the Lord by keeping the Archa Vigraha Archavatar at home or in temple.
Yeah, so now you may think, okay, that means deity worship is only for neophytes who are called Kanishtha Adhikaris. It's not for advanced devotees, you may think. But if you see advanced personalities like Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu worshipped Jagannath Baladev Subhadra in Odisha, and like Ramanuja worshipped Ranganath, and Madhvacharya, he arranged Ashtamathas, where the worship was allowed to be done only by sannyasis, for the Udupi Krishna as well as the other Ashtamatha deities also. Are the neophytes? They are such advanced acharyas. Similarly, Shankaracharya established Badri Vishal in Badrinath. So you will find that our acharyas have not only installed the deities, they have personally loved, worshipped the deities. The difference is what? The neophyte does it as a duty. He becomes a Brahman, he gets Brahman Diksha, and he may enter the altar, and he may, you know, dress the Lord, ornament the Lord, feed Him bhoga, and he may do it as a duty. And some of them may take the Mahaprasad also, isn't it? He's a neophyte, Kanishtha Adhikari. But as he keeps doing, he comes to Madhyam Adhikari stage, then Uttam Adhikari stage, then he sees the Lord as non-different from the spiritual personality in the spiritual world. And there is absolutely no difference between the two. Pratimatu Meenahi Sakshat Prajendra Nandan, like the Chaitanya Mahaprabhu says. So Chaitanya Mahaprabhu told the pastime of Madhavendra Puri, and Nityananda Prabhu told the pastime of Sakshi Gopal. Nityananda Prabhu told Chaitanya Mahaprabhu pastime of Sakshi Gopal, and Chaitanya Mahaprabhu told the Kshirsur Gopinath pastime of Madhavendra Puri. So both the Lords, Gaur Nitai, have revealed one great deity pastime. One of the Gopal as well as Kshirsur Gopinath, and the other one is about Sakshi Gopal. And in both these pastimes, you see the Lord reciprocating with the devotees, you find. So it's not that the worship is only for the neophytes. It's actually very good for neophytes, otherwise neophytes can easily be carried away by Maya. But by having deity worship, they have a chance to become fixed up and grow, like that he says. Yeah. Yes, what is deity worship?
What is deity worship? God is spirit, but as Krishna reveals in Bhagavad Gita, matter is His energy. Because we cannot perceive spirit in our present condition, Krishna allows us to see Him in His deity form made up of material elements. He tells us that the deity installed according to the directions of scriptures is identical to Him. Deity worship is an important process to purify our vision so that we can eventually see Krishna's spiritual form. Therefore, deity worship must be performed with attention and devotion. It is a tangible way to serve God directly in our present state. Deity worship is not idol worship, but is the worship of Lord according to His instructions.
Yeah, according to His instructions, yeah. So it's a tangible way to serve God. So deity form is actually a spiritual form visible to our material eyes. It is said, so our mundane vision otherwise can't see Him. Say, for example, if somebody draws the picture of a very, very poor beggar, you know, with disheveled hair and tattered clothes, with a begging bowl in the hand. You know, he is crying tears like this. If you see a picture like that, immediately it evokes compassion in your heart. That means in your heart and mind, there is some emotion that is aroused by seeing certain pictures. How many of you have experienced when you see certain pictures, some emotions arise in your mind? Correct, no? Yeah. Similarly, if somebody sees some dirty picture in the internet, it comes on the screen, that evokes lust in a person, correct, no? So in the mind and heart, we all have experience. It awakens, it agitates our senses, it awakens our mind. Either favorable emotions arise or unfavorable emotions arise by watching those things. Now, if the deity form of the Lord is made as per the description given in the scripture, so when you look at this form of the Lord made of one of the eight elements, it awakens the soul's emotions. Just as those pictures awaken your mental emotions, the soul's emotions are awakened because the Lord looks exactly like this in the spiritual world and He performs many pastimes. So you read the scripture on one hand, on the other hand, you are watching the reading. So we are doing Pancharatriki and Bhagavad Vidhi, both we are doing. Bhagavad Vidhi means Shravanam Kirtanam, we do. Shravanam Kirtanam Smaranam. And Pancharatriki Vidhi is to worship the Lord very nicely. So when you combine these two, then it will be very effective and very powerful in reviving our lost relationship with the Lord. And then it becomes a very tangible way to serve the Lord directly. So we will discuss more tomorrow on this topic. Now let us take the questions now. This is the one? Okay, read it quickly. Narayana.
From Pune is asking, Prabhuji, how should we answer to people who think that ISKCON does business?
Yeah, so you can tell them that whatever items we sell are all devotional items. We don't do any non-devotional items. You come and see in our stall, number one. Number two, you ask anybody coming to our stall that the things that you are coming to purchase here, do you want us to keep the stall open or you can close down this shop? Everybody says we want the stall. So based on need based, we have opened this stall. And in case you feel the rates are exorbitant, please make a note that every penny that is coming is going to Lord Vrindavan Chandra's service. So your money is best utilized. It is not used for any other bad purpose, like outside. Outside companies, if they make profit, they may use the money for drinking, smoking, and bad things. Whereas here, even if you think some rates are exorbitant, that money is ultimately going for Vrindavan Chandra's dress, or ornaments, or bhoga, such kinds of things only. Yeah, next.
Sai Varun Prabhu from Chennai is asking, my mother follows Mayavadi path. Whenever she watches lectures of devotee, she ridicules philosophy and devotees. Is it better to make her or not hear our lectures or make her hoping that she will change slowly? What is the best way I can help her in Krishna consciousness?
No, it is best not to allow her to hear devotee lectures. If you do that, it will be 9th offense. Because she doesn't have faith and you are forcing her to hear, and by offending the devotees and the Lord, she will degrade in her spiritual life. It is best that she doesn't associate. Yes. Next.
Bhimraj Prabhu is asking, Hare Krishna Prabhu, in certain circumstances, conditions, the situation comes that we are not able to do morning program in the terms of Mangal Aarti or any other basic Aarti completely proper way. Like we may have to sing it very fast due to time constraint, or we may have to skip some Hare Krishna Mahamantra after Aarti. Or sometimes we find, sometimes we write and we just say Pamho to the devotee. So what should be done in certain similar conditions, Prabhuji? Please guide.
Okay, whatever time is available in that only we can do fit. Pamho, AGT, SP is not a problem. You are conveying what is to be conveyed. They also understand it. And sometimes aartis have to be done short because your exam is there or something. So in half an hour you finish Mangalarti, Narsingarti, Tulsi Arati, everything. Sometimes we do that. Once in a while we do it. It's not a regular thing. No problem. Yeah. Then Krishnadas Prabhu, Hyderabad.
For a brahmachari who is struggling with his mind and senses, what you will suggest? Would determination continue or move out and get married and continue? What you would have done if you would have been in that same place?
Everybody has trouble with their mind and senses. Who doesn't have trouble? Krishna uses the stoka. He says, Shaknoti haivayas sodum praksharira vimokshanat kama krodot bhavam vegam sayukta sasuki naraha. He says that up to the last breath, when the jiva, you know, leaves the body, till then you have to control the kama krodha lobha. And there is some amount of pressure from inside, from the kama karma bijas, we say, the seeds of past sinful tendencies is pushing us from inside, and outside there are many sense objects attracting. But actually, when we are seriously engaged in Krishna service and constantly engaged in Krishna service, you know, these things will become very, they won't be able to allure you so much. You will see that they become very feeble. Because you are continuously engaged in Krishna service and you are serious and you are Goloka bent. At any cost I will attain Krishna. So that determination will help us to continue. But in case you are losing your determination to continue, and say the easiest thing I will tell you how you should know. If your mind becomes preoccupied with thoughts of marriage, job, and you are becoming absorbed in it and consumed by it, that means you are actually not a brahmachari candidate at all. You are in the wrong place. A brahmachari may occasionally feel little like a spike coming when he sees something, but it doesn't last for a very long time. It just evaporates after that. He is happy chanting, dancing, taking prasad, meeting devotees, reading books and relishing shastra. Sometimes we study something in the shastra, we feel like dancing. Hare bol, see what Krishna says, what the devotees say. So in this way, brahmachari can very easily overcome the troubles which come by complete absorption in spiritual platform. But if somebody is staring at the sky and thinking, what if I have to change after 40? Mera kya hoga? Or, you know, in case maybe I should keep in touch with my old company boss if I have to return back to the same job. That means he's not a brahmachari actually. He is in the wrong place wasting time, I would say. Better he leaves the ashram, goes to company and does them something. Yeah, next.
Prashant Roo from Kanpur. Prabhuji, Krishna is already present in heart, accompanying the soul. Then what does it mean that Krishna will come in our heart when it's clean and help in further advancement? As it is already there in everyone's heart, clean or not? Reference to Gundicha Margin.
Yeah. Actually, right now only super soul is there in your heart. But we are going for Bhagavan realization. So that Bhagavan, Radha and Krishna, they will come and reside in our heart. Currently, Krishna has deputed the super soul, which is his plenary expansion, to take care of you. You know, once you become a completely devoted, you know, devotee of Krishna, then Radha and Krishna will become completely, they will come and reside in the heart for all time. Yeah, that is one thing. And another thing, Sva Antasthena Gadabhrita, that verse says, Bhavat Vida Bhagavata Stirta Bhuta Swayam Vibho Tirti Kurvanti Tirthani Sva Antasthena Gadabhrita. That means super soul may be in everybody's heart, but it's not yet awakened. It means, you know, do you really know super soul is in your heart, Prashant Prabhu from Kanpur? Why, you will not be able to realize anything about the super soul. We just say it theoretically. We have no realization of it. Who can say with realization? One who has awakened the super soul and he is actually taking instruction from super soul. He is in active touch with the super soul. Then he is watching the super soul. Otherwise, super soul has put a complete iron curtain between you and him. You can't see him because you want sense gratification. He will not show himself to you. When we turn away from sense gratification and towards him and beg him for shelter and beg him for purification, and then at that time, super soul also will say, in which form you want to see me? Ito narsimho, parato narsimho. And then he says, Bahir Narsimha, Hrdaya Narsimha, because Prahlad wanted to see Lord in what form? Narsimha form. So the super soul, in the place of super soul, he saw Narsimha. In our case, in the place of, you know, super soul, we will see Radha Krishna, we will see. Yeah, next.
Chandrakala from Hyderabad. Hare Krishna Prabhuji, as you said in previous class, that one should take bath early in the morning only after cleaning the stomach. If one has a constipation problem, can the person take direct bath and worship the deity?
Yeah, that has to be done. You take bath and worship the deity, and later on there will be a clearing call. Then you do that clearing call and then take a bath again. That time. Second time you will take a bath again. Okay, and then Krishna's Prabhu is asking from Hyderabad, without any dirty dream or any wrong contemplation, I lose him and every day, every 15 days, I do not know why. Actually, that is due to contemplation on enjoying contemplation during the daytime, by which the dormant semen in the body, which is like a steam turning into water. Like that, the dormant steam from the top of the head to tip of the toe, that actually turns, it becomes condensed. In Bhagavatam, the word is used, the semen is dislocated, it says, dislodged or dislocated, which means when you see some dirty sight, that time the semen forms. So we should not, a brahmachari should not allow the semen only to form at all. Which means the semen is an evaporated state in the body. One should keep it as it is. In that state only, then you will be very vibrant spiritually. But otherwise, if you allow it to form semen, then it flows downwards. Then you can't be urdhvaretas. Urdhvaretas means it flow upward to the head. Yeah.
Prachur Prabhu. Prabhuji, yesterday you gave an example that if an ant or hair has fallen in a plate of prasadam, then it's contaminated. What to do with that plate of prasadam? Even if it has fallen in our plate, we have to do same thing. If the fingers touch the glass of water we are about to drink, we have to throw that also?
Yeah. Actually, that plate of prasadam we can put in an area of the ants where all the ants can consume it. They will finish it. Then you can again wash the plate and take fresh prasad, you can take. Yeah, no problem. No, don't try to touch the drinking water with your finger, put the finger inside. We have to learn it. The main point is we have to learn. Yes, Manikanta Prabhu is asking. I saw a devotee who is my equal, who always keeps some remnants outside plate while honoring prasad. I felt bad to see and said to him to keep them in his plate only. But he felt bad and unable to change his behavior. How to deal in situation? Achha, he's keeping on the floor, I think. It's not very clean. Yeah, it should not be kept outside. It should be kept inside. Maybe you can tell his senior. If you tell he feels bad, then his senior can tell him. So Bhavin Sonar Prabhu is asking from VIT voice. By applying oil after bath, do we become contaminated? On the head, if you apply oil after the bath. I don't think there is a problem of applying coconut oil or something on the head after bath. I don't see any problem. Vikram Prabhu, preferably which water bath is better to remain goodness, hot water or cold water bath? Actually, it should be like neutral water. Too much cold water causes vata problem for some people. And too much hot water weakens the senses and the body also. Too much hot, very smoky hot water is not very good. It weakens the body and increases the nerves problem, nervous diseases and all. So too hot water is not good. Too chill water is not good. Moderate water is good. And is there any procedure to take bath specifically with cold water bath? Or we should take directly water over the head? Actually, while taking bath, one should sing the holy names. Then it becomes a devasnanam, they say like that. You're singing the holy name and you're taking the bath. Of course, you put, as I told you, if you put water over the head towards the end, then you will not catch cold. And then wash other parts of the body first, yeah. And Satyajivan Prabhu is asking, what should be the rule for washing dishes after passing prasadam at home? It should be done immediately or whenever we get time. Then if you keep it in the kitchen, then cockroaches will come, as I told you. Because they see some eatables left out. So, actually when you are cooking, we can put all of them in the washing area, dip it in water. If it is dipped in water, it's very easy to wash later on. So it is best if you can wash as soon as possible without keeping for a long time, wherever we are doing. Himanshu Prabhu from Palamu is asking, as you explained that the Lord being absolute is non-different from deity, is it same for the spiritual master? Because we pray spiritual master as deity or photo. Actually, spiritual master is also treated like that. Why? Because there is super soul in his heart and our heart. And we call it as a director within and preceptor without. So you will be surprised to know, Guru knows certain things about you. How he knew, only super soul knows. He can give information. Prabhupada said, the super soul tells the Guru about you as much as Guru needs to know. So therefore, Guru also we can treat like the way we treat the Lord, yeah. And Anuk Prabhu is asking, if you are wearing clothes, slept for some time and taking bath, or you've gone for passing stool and then took bath, then for that particular day can wear, yeah, you can wear the same dress, no problem. We don't have to keep washing every time. Only morning you wear fresh clothes After that, you can remove it and then take bath and wear the same clothes. You don't have to again and again keep washing. Sometimes the devotee is touching feet while chanting in the temple hall in front of deities or while reading Prabhupada's books. No. I also know that. It's very bad it is. Like, you know, they put the hand like this over the feet and keep rubbing. And they have to go and wash the hand. It's very bad. Actually, we have to cover the feet with our dhoti like this. We should not touch the feet. It's very bad. Raja Prabhu, is any and every photo of Krishna non-different from Krishna or only those of deities installed? Especially if the deities have lotus feet, having in photo, they have to be treated just like the deity. But in any case, whenever you see Krishna's picture, devotee treats the Lord just like the Lord only. He doesn't treat in any other way. I live with my parents. What to do as they ask me to eat food cooked with onion garlic? Oh, you can tell them politely that if you eat onion garlic, your brain will become dull and you will get poor marks in the examination. If they want you to be a topper in the class, no onion, no garlic, tell them. Srinidhar Prabhu is asking from Bhubaneswar, how to become self-confident both materially and spiritually in every situation and how to come out of sentimentalism? Actually, these how to questions are all having a very typical answer. Associate with those who are very confidently doing spiritual life and take guidance from them, ask them what they do, take their help. So, more questions? How many more? My Lord, many more. No, I won't be able to complete. So, the other unanswered questions will be answered by someone. Thank you all very much. It's time now. Shri Prabhupada ki. Thank you very much. Hare Krishna.